Hey, this is Steve Gill with your Daily Notes update for August 3rd, 2011. Well, the debt limit battle is over, at least for now, although more fights lay ahead as we try to get control of the out-of-control spending and keep Washington from raising our taxes. But with the battle over, Barack Obama has now returned his attention to fighting on the jobs front. That's right, for the seventh time by at least any count, Barack Obama says he's going to return his attention to jobs. Even though he's promised in the past to relentlessly focus on creating jobs, to never rest until he creates jobs, to make sure he creates jobs, for at least the seventh time, he says he's once again turning his focus to jobs and to raising taxes. The Obama administration is saying that the real problem with the debt deal is that it doesn't force the rich to pay anything. Like the rich are getting a free ride in this country. The bottom line is the top 1% of income earners in this country pay 38% of the federal income tax burden while earning 20% of the adjusted gross income. That's right, the top 1%, the evil rich that Barack Obama and the Democrats say are paying nothing, actually pay 38% of the total federal income tax tab while earning 20% of the total federal income. They're paying nearly twice as much as they pull in, and the Democrats say they're not pulling any share, much less their fair share. The bottom line is that the bottom half in this country pay nothing. Zip, zero, nada. If we're going to actually share the pain of taxes, let's share them with everybody and not continue to punish those who are actually putting something into the till. If we're going to restrain spending in Washington, sending more isn't going to do it. But if we're going to create a fairer tax system, making sure that everybody has a stake in the game does make some sense. Right now, half of us are getting a free ride. It's time to cure that before we start punishing those who are actually paying with more punishment. We've punished our way to the prosperity we're enjoying. We've punished our way to an economy that doesn't work. Let's start rewarding success instead of punishing it. We'll talk more about it in the next edition. I'm Steve Gill. This is The Steve Gill Show.